It'll be the Iolani Raiders hosting the St. Louis Crusaders in ILH Division I boys varsity basketball action. Hello, everybody. I'm John Tamanaha alongside Mike Among, and we're with you here again, having just seen the Iolani girls team defeat Sacred Hearts in a somewhat lopsided game, 60-24 earlier. Here's another team from our friends up on Wailea Avenue, Iolani versus St. Louis.
Yeah, there's a nice buzz in the air. The gym's starting to fill up. Again, just like the last game, you know, these players, they sometimes get tired of playing against each other in practice and working on things, and it's exciting to put the uniform on and lace them up and go against somebody else.
Absolutely. Iolani comes in 2-0 on the season. They opened up league play last week with a big 49-38 victory over Punahou, and then followed that up on Saturday evening with a 53-37 win at Mid-Pacific.
Yeah, I spoke to Coach Dean Shimamoto during the week and earlier today. And he's worried about St. Louis. He's got there's a lot of athletes up the street, and he wants to make sure that they work for everything that they get. On the flip side, Coach Alan Silva, his first, second, and third keys to the game were to take care of number 50, which is big Hugh Hoagland, which probably gives opposing coaches nightmares. And he said, we just got to come and play, you know, like, hey, this is why you play. You want this kind of challenge. He was very focused, he's ready to go, and I'm sure he's got his team ready to go too. They look like they were all business.
And at the moment, St. Louis comes in, and they're at the other end of the league standings at 0-2. They dropped their opener to Kamehameha up at Kamehameha, 55-49, and then lost to Punahou on Saturday, 88-60. Both of those games are on the road. Obviously, this one is as well, and their next game is at Marinal. So,
wow.
St. Louis in a tough stretch. And now we'll go to public address announcer Kyle Miyamoto for the starting lineups.
Hello, basketball fans, and welcome to Iolani School for Boys ILH Varsity Basketball. We kindly ask for your cooperation to please be positive and display good sportsmanship in your cheers, comments, and actions towards all the players, coaches, support staff, game officials, and fellow spectators. Also, for the safety of our student athletes, no flash photography is allowed during this event. At this time, we'd like to introduce the starting lineups, beginning first with the visiting St. Louis Crusaders. At guard, a 5'11 senior, number 1, Jameson Nunuha. At forward, a 6'6 junior, number 20, Jalen Smith. At forward, a 6'4 junior, number 21, Chris Sykes. At guard, a 5'11 junior, number 23, Noah Purcell. And at center, a 6'4 junior, number 55, Josh White. The head coach of the Crusaders is Alan Silva. And now your starting lineup for your home, Iolani Raiders. At guard, a 5'11 senior, number 11, Helom Baldomero. At guard, a 6-foot junior, number 20, Ryan Van Canford. At guard, a 5'9 sophomore, number 22, Noah Bumonglob. At forward, a 6'4 junior, number 24, Cole Hoagland. And at forward, a 6'9 senior, number 50, Hugh Hoagland. The head coach of your Raiders is Dean Shimamoto.
Thank you, Kyle. We're moments away from getting this one started. Last year, Iolani and St. Louis played a couple pivotal games, and we'll get to that, some of those stories later on in the broadcast. But just in short, St. Louis had a really great start. They're 0-2 today, but they had a really great start and really kind of shocked ILH. Punahou, Iolani were kind of at the other end. Iolani at one point lost 3 in a row.
Yeah, St. Louis, they were in the driver's seat early on last year.
And then Iolani won that second matchup. The first matchup, Iolani lost 52-50. And then Raiders came back and kind of went on a run. And that run ended with the ILH and the state championships. This one is underway. Hoagland wins the tap to Baldemel. This is Bu Monglug, Noah. Was on the varsity last year as a freshman. Baldemero, his opening shot off the mark. And St. Louis will get their first possession.
I think Helam was surprised to find himself so wide open, so close to the basket.
One of the first things you notice about St. Louis is the size of one Josh White there, number 55 in the far corner. He's got the ball right now. Watched him in the Punahou webcast on Saturday, and he's taking and hitting three-pointers and doing a lot of different things.
Again, early feeling out process, seeing what defense the other team is in.
Chris Sykes out to Noah Purcell. He gets it taken away by Helan Baldemero. And ahead to Van Cantfort. Baldemero. Hugh Hoagland gets his first touch. Out to his brother, Cole. Back to Hugh. He'll take a jump shot, 14 feet. Sinks up.
Nice jump shot. Beautiful defense last time by Helan Baldemero.
And there's that three-point prowess of Josh White. Doesn't make it, but Noah Purcell is there to clean up the action. Tie this game at 2. Just getting started here in the first quarter. Hoagland's got it in deep. Kicks it back out. Finds his way to Van Cantfort. His three-point attempt rolls around.
In and out.
Here is Noah Purcell. If you follow ILH football, you know all about Noah Purcell. Coach Cal Lee, the football coach at St. Louis, refers to him as the heart of the St. Louis defense. And that is the defense of the Open Division champions. Raiders with it, and we've got a timeout called by St. Louis coach Alan Silva, 30-second timeout.
Early timeout for Coach Silva here. Let's see if we can figure out what's going on in that huddle.
Well, his 1, 2, and 3 was...
Take care of Hoagland, take care of Hoagland. Well, he's got two Hoaglands to take care of tonight, too.
So maybe one of those, two of them were for Hugh, one of them were for Cole. He was getting the ball in some dangerous positions there in the lane, high post, and once down in the low block.
Well, Cole had a really good game the last time out, and Coach Shimamoto was saying, you know, if he moves off the ball when Hugh has it, Hugh's an excellent passer. He's leading the team in assists. He'll find cutters to the basket, or he'll find open guys for three. Looks like they changed their defense to a 1-3-1. Let's see how much they trap or how much they pack it in. Looks like they're just kind of sitting in.
It's Cole with it. Cross court. Quickly to Van Kempfert. His three-point attempt's long. And they're going to get, I think, Hugh Hoagland over the back of Josh White.
Looks like they're going to let the Raiders shoot over the top of the defense and just try to box out and rebound. Get possessions that way.
Sykes, the free throw line. His jumper's all net over Hugh Hoagland.
That was a little feathery floater right there.
Baldemero. Hugh again at the high post. Good monlug, a good penetration and dish to Cole. Shuffled his feet.
Nice pass by Bumonglug. Cole has to be ready to go up right away with that.
Crusaders leading by a bucket. 5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Jalen Smith with a three-pointer. Attempt, no good. Is Bumonglug in transition. Raiders pushing the tempo. And Coach Dean Shimamoto will make a couple of substitutions. Bailey Alabanza in for Cole Hoagland. And Justin Genovia in for Noah Bumonglug.
Yeah, looks like he's looking for some energy off the bench again.
This is Genovia. Alabanza. Keelan Baldomero, his three-point attempt is long. The ball slips out of the hands of Van Cantford, out of bounds. Turnover Raiders.
Nice offensive rebound. Just got to take care of that ball. Keep the possession. Kind of a slow start by the Raiders here.
Purcell to Lunuha. Down and low to Josh White working against Hugh Hoagland. Josh White does well by himself. Hugh's averaging 3.3 blocks per game. Sometimes when you see the games, it seems like more than that. Changing a lot of shots, affecting offense. He has two fouls.
Two
he has
quick
both
fouls.
Of Iolani's fouls.
Yeah, that's one way to take care of number 50.
There's that delicate touch of Josh White. Gets that shooter's roll.
Coach Silva has to be pleased at this start here.
Josh White makes both.
All right, they have to solve this 1-3-1. Move the ball, expect the trap in the corner. Keep moving it, attack the gaps.
There's Cole Hoagland in the gap. Back out. Genovia being harassed by Nanuha. That forces a turnover. There's Noah Purcell. Sykes can't get it to go. Alabanza push it up ahead to Van Cantford. This cross-court pass intercepted immediately by Nanuha. And this is Sykes. His jumper goes. Crusaders now lead it by six.
Sykes got a nice little touch on him. Sweet shot.
3.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Another turnover. Steal by Nanuha. Over to Purcell. And the Crusaders will get another shot at it.
Right now, Crusaders playing with a lot more energy than the Raiders. And it shows on the scoreboard.
Jalen Smith with it. He is the son of Alika Smith. And way out to the top of the circle to Jamison Nunuha. Jamison's averaging 13 points per game in league play. There's Jalen. St. Louis going into somewhat of a deliberate offense. Ball finds its way into the hands of Noah Purcell, and he makes a layup. That calls Iolani coach Dean Shimamoto to call a 30-second timeout. His team trails it by 8. 2:36 to go, first quarter.
Yeah, coach wants to get their attention here with this timeout. He's probably going to ask for some more energy, more intensity. St. Louis, like I said, is winning the energy battle, getting loose balls, pushing the ball, more active on defense. With Hugh having two fouls, it's going to be, you know, the teammates are going to be called upon to step it up. Where do you get your leadership from? Let's see. seniors and the other veterans can step up here.
Into the game for Iolani is Frank Felix, number 14. Gets a good inside-out pass to Noah Bumanglug, who hits the three-pointer.
Felix with an assist and a steal.
And a bounce pass and maybe an assist. No. And there's Genovia.
There's some energy.
Good timeout by Dean Shimamoto. And now Alan Silva needs to call a 30 to counter what Iolani did. Bumangla came back in the game. Felix came into the game for the first time, and that brought some energy.
Yeah, you know, Cole Hoagland did not get that rebound, but he got in there and he battled and he tapped it to his teammate and got the easy layup. I think it was Genovia, right?
Yes, Genovia under the basket.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's a lot better coming out of that timeout. St. Louis is a dangerous team. You can't let them hang around. Let's see if the Raiders can tie it up here and pull ahead soon.
Jamison Anuha over to Noah Purcell, members of the St. Louis football team. This is Sykes. It's double team, but gets away. It's a down low to Josh White. The ball bounces off his knee. And
Frankie Felix.
Bounds.
Sorry, Frankie Felix making another play there.
Frankie new to the varsity. They brought him up last year for the end of the season. 6 foot sophomore. It's Cole Hoagland. Good long lug. He has a three-pointer. He'll try another from this side, and it's the same result. Noah Bumanglo, he's got 6 and a couple threes.
I like the way he's fixed his shot a little bit. If you remember from last year, oh, another steal by Felix.
Wow.
Sorry, I'll finish my thought later.
Cole Hoagland initiates the contact and is called for an offensive foul. 13th foul on Iolani. They're all on Hoagland's.
Bumanglug, last year we called his shot looking like a old Jamal Wilkes shot, kind of from behind his ear, corkscrew type of shot. He's got that thing straightened out a little bit better this year.
Jamal Wilkes, I love it.
Yeah.
We used to try to do that in the park. Steal by Iolani.
Oh, beautiful pass. Oh.
Great pass to Felix. He went up and he was fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot 2.
Felix stepping up.
Absolutely. Inserted into the lineup after that first 30-second timeout by Iolani.
It's good to have hungry bench players that that can come and put a little jolt in their starters.
Yeah, that happened immediately. Felix has 1 of 2, but now the Raiders have the lead. 11-10. Under a minute to go, first quarter.
That time only half of the team was in a press. The other half had dropped back. Got to communicate a little better.
Quinones gets on the board for St. Louis. Give the Crusaders the lead. Raiders with it. 40 seconds to go. Entry pass to Cameron Chang. It's knocked out of bounds. Cameron came in a little while ago for Cole Hoagland. More substitutions here for Iolani. Van Canfert in along with Baldomero, placing Bailey Alabanza and Justin Genovia. Here is Baldomero.
St. Louis
gets loose. Can't finish.
St. Louis changes to a man-to-man defense. Looks like Coach Alan Silva mixing up his defenses, trying to find the right one. Bumangla with a beautiful drive to the basket.
Yeah. Noel, 5'9" sophomore. According to my records, he grew 2 inches since the last time we were here calling a game.
That's always good. Thank you, Felix. You gotta love it.
Yeah, thank you, Felix. Really bringing something to the table here for Iolani.
Just a sophomore.
We've got a whistle. Huh?
Again, Felix almost making the steal. Unfortunately, got the foul.
Noah Brown, number 13, into the game for St. Louis. He inbounds to Keavi Silva. Being watched closely by Helam Baldomero. Helam, a great defender on both the Iolani basketball team and football team. Junior Wiley, attempt at the buzzer is long. St. Louis leading it 12-11 after the first quarter. Hugh Hoagland will be back in to start the second along with Bailey Alabanza. If you're just joining us, Hugh picked up 2 quick personal fouls, Iolani's first 2 fouls of the game. It sat for quite a while.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see if he can stay out of that third foul for the whole second quarter. I'm sure Coach Shimamoto will have to sub him out if he picks that up.
That's not been a problem for him this season. All trouble. But today he picked up 2 quick ones. We're looking at the Iolani huddle here. And holdover coaches are Coach Cord and Coach Bryson. But there's 2 new coaches. You got Jared Awakawa.
Lefty.
Back in there. And Kenji Price, who both bring interesting things to the Iolani coaching staff.
Yeah, I heard a little bit of Coach Kenji brings like a lot of the mental aspect of
Coach Shimamoto refers to it as an experiential coach. Kenji's done a lot of things in his time, including Army Rangers. And is now a lawyer and has a vast wealth of experience in life and in sports. And Jared Awakawa, of course, the former University of Hawaii left-handed pitcher and Iolani star and quarterback and basketball player. Good idea there by Silva, trying to find Noah Brown cutting to the basket, but the ball goes out of bounds.
Yeah. Iolani defensive pressure, you know, Coach Alan Silva mentioned it early. He said they play great defense. We're going to have to just handle it. That time, defense forced a turnover.
Alabanza's pass toward Hugh Hoagland, knocked away. Here come the Crusaders. Loi Rivera, fancy dribbling, loses control. Here's Alabanza with it. Knocked away from Baldomero. Here come the Crusaders. Rivera, his pass intercepted by Helam Baldomero.
That's a high action defense going on here. Alabanza hit that. Oh.
In and out for Bailey, one of Iolani's better 3-point shooters. Bailey actually didn't play in the league opener against Punahou. He was sick. The rest of the Raiders picked up the slack in a big opening victory. Punahou, very good club this year and last year. We saw them in the Iolani Prep Basketball Classic. They did very well.
State finals last year.
Yeah. Noah Brown all the way to the basket. Hugh Hoagland clears, and he will dribble up court.
Yeah.
Genovia collides with Quinones hard. He's used to things like that, being a wide receiver on the Raider football team.
Yeah, he's not afraid of attacking the basket, Justin.
Justin made a first team All-State list after the football season.
Nice to have a 6'9 guy that can grab a defensive rebound and lead the break coming the other way. Hugh that time finding Genovia in the corner.
Genovia converts his first free throw.
Cole Hoagland coming in for Ryan Van Kentfort.
Genovia makes them both. He's got four. Here's Sykes. Lob to Josh White. Can't connect with him. Raiders quickly. That pass knocked out of bounds by Purcell.
Yeah, they're going to have to start making some ball fakes before trying to pass into Hugh. Everybody's expecting it.
Genovia thought about three-pointer. He'll drive the lane instead. Gets fouled by maybe two Crusaders. Coach Silva disagrees.
Yeah, one of the Crusaders got ball, but I think the second one probably got some body there or some arm.
They called it on Jameson Anuha. Third free throw in a row for Justin.
We have many multi-sport athletes here on this basketball team.
Raiders up by three. They knocked the ball out of bounds. St. Louis still retains possession.
I love to watch Helam play defense. He's so athletic, it's ridiculous.
Josh White, three-pointer off the front of the rim. Alabanza, a nice rebound. Elam with it, looking for Hugh. Gets it to Cole instead. Gino. 2 point from NBA distance. No good. St. Louis quickly into the front court. What's the call there? Because, I would think Anuha stepped on the line or was fouled, but it's... I'm not sure what happened there.
I think... Oh, great steal by Alabanza. I think he was going to call a foul on Hugh, but I think he probably decided not to so Hugh could stay in the game. I'm not sure why.
And I guess it kind of worked out because Alabanza got the steal in the corner, so it was what we call athletic justice.
Uh-huh.
There's a kick.
Either that or he was going to call a foul, but stepped on the line. I'm not sure about that one.
Yeah, that was peculiar. Raiders leading it by three. 4:15 to go here, second quarter. And Jameson Nanuha sinks a runner and will go to the line to try and complete a three-point play.
Nanuha's a great player. Smooth.
St. Louis' leading scorer, 13 points a game, has hit 12 three-pointers on the season, so you got to come out and respect that, and then he drives. And see what the Raiders come up with here. Hoagland versus Josh White. It's halfway into the lane. Helam Baldomero, three-pointer. That's no good. It's Jameson Anuha. Purcell with a strong move inside after driving the lane. Driving the baseline.
Going right at Hugh Hoagland, knowing that Hugh has two fouls.
Bailey Alabanza's three doesn't draw iron. I don't think they're going to get Smith for corralling the rebound with his foot on the out of bounds. There's Frank Felix in for the second time. Let's keep an eye on him. He brought a whole lot of energy to the Raiders squad in the first quarter. He will try a jump shot. In and out. Inuha lost his footing, and Hugh will get a blocked shot there, and now he's running the court. He'll lay it off, but not before walking with the ball a little bit.
Yeah, Hughes is frustrated. He wants to get more involved offensively. You can tell he pushed that up like a point guard again, which is a great luxury.
Hughes got two of Iolani's 15 points, but as we mentioned earlier, two of Iolani's five fouls. They're going to get a Raider for a push in the back on Jalen Smith.
First of all, on the Raiders, number 14, Frank Felix.
I think that's two on Frankie.
Jamison Nunuha spells his first name J-A-Y-M-A-S-O-N. I like it. Here's Noah Purcell. Jump stop in the lane and tried to get it to White. Sails out of bounds. Here's Noah Bumonglug. He gets it back, give and go, lays it up. That can't go. Third attempt. Let's see if Hogan can get a third attempt. He can't. It's knocked away. Bumongla applying some pressure in the backcourt to Purcell. Nunuha takes it to the basket, rejected by Hugh Hoglan. And Frank Felix collects the rebound.
Yeah, you gotta love that energy that Frank brings. Nice block by Hugh down here defensively. He's wide open. He's got to take that to the bucket.
He does for a little bit, and bounce pass over to Hugh, who converts. Knocked away by Cole Hoagland.
Yeah, unfortunate. He got his hand on the ball, just having to bounce off his foot there.
Junior Wiley in for St. Louis, replacing Josh White. Somewhat of a frenetic pace, a little bit different for what we're normally seeing from Iolani, which is not a deliberate offense, but typically try to control the tempo. But Iolani fell behind. It was 10-2. They've made that up and then some, now leading it by one. So that pace did suit them.
Yes.
Junior Wiley in the lane, nice floater. There's Ryan Van Cantfort. Elam Baldomero working against Purcell. Back to Van Cantfort. Inside to Hoagland, and he is fouled. To get Junior Wiley on that one.
They're really making Hugh work hard for his position and to get the ball there. We're sending two extra guys at him.
Hugh, the left-handed jump hook, short. St. Louis with it. They lead by one, 52 seconds to go here until halftime. Got a whistle on Smith's drive. Foul called on Van Kampfer.
Yeah, that's one of those judgment calls. You know, look clean from here, but the ref had a different angle.
Jaden can't add to their Crusader lead, and Iolani has it. Let's see what they do.
Chance to take the lead.
Maybe last shot here. It's poked away instead by Junior Wiley. Here's Baldomero, 20 seconds. Then Kentford, 12. Sorry, Bumonglug with it now. Hoagland and Smith got tied up. Be out of bounds. That's the sixth team foul on St. Louis. Raiders have 8.6 seconds here. Close the first half. Knocked away out of bounds by Nunuha.
2.4 seconds.
Yeah, Iolani will have 2.4 to go. And Kenford gets it to Frank Felix. He's got to shoot. He does, and it's short. So we'll go to the intermission. St. Louis leading it 18-17. Interesting game so far, Coach.
Yeah, Coach Silva has to be pleased going into the locker room with a one-point lead. You know, he changed defensive effectively. They neutralized Hugh. They bothered him. They harassed him. They got him frustrated. He got those early fouls. Changed the complexion of the game that early. You know, it seemed like Iolani was going to get themselves back in it and possibly take the lead. But St. Louis put on another run of their own.
We are going to be entertained at halftime here by a pair of groups representing the Iolani Dance Team. Iolani Dance Team, a very busy group. They perform throughout the year at football halftime shows along with the Iolani Marching Band and participate in the marching band competitions. And they do very well in those. And here at basketball halftimes.
Yeah, they're a very dedicated group of people. The teachers, the coaches, the dancers, starting at a very young age.
First up, we're going to have the Team Red, they call them. And they're going to do a jazz funk routine. And this is choreographed by Allison Kim, class of 13. Good job there by the red team.
Terrific. Lots
and then
of my...
now we'll get a taste of the black team. The red team was comprised of students in grades 7 to 11. This black team has some seniors in it, so they're a group from 7 to 12. And this routine was also choreographed by Allison Kim, class of 17, but also with Jamie Lee, her class of 13 classmate. Job by the Iolani dance team.
Wow.
Under the direction of Serene Okimura, Allison Kim, who choreographed both of those routines, along with her classmate, Jamie Lee, and Chelsea Hirano.
I'm glad they're not asking us to comment on the dancing.
Oh, come on. You're an expert at, what is it, jazz funk routines? Which one?
Yeah.
But I will tell you... that was cool to watch on this two-and-a-half-camera shoot that we've got here. Kudos to our ILH Live and One Team Network crew that consists of Dane Kurihara, our producer, director, engineer up there, Mitch Viernes with the court cam down low, Maddie Ikeda, ILH Senior up here high, and Rita Wecki on the sound.
We actually had a cameo there, a special appearance, Sam Cropsey.
Yeah.
Got into the routine a little bit in the middle of that one.
Yeah. We saw all sides of Sam Cropsey's head. That was cool to see. We're at halftime here. Iolani leading or trailing St. Louis 18-17. Crusaders looking for their first win in an ILH play. Iolani, they are 0-2. Iolani looking to move to 3-0. Raiders are, of course, the defending and 11-time state champions. What do the numbers tell you, Coach?
Well, it looks like we got Justin Genovia and Noah Umonglog with 6 points each. Hugh Hoagland with 4 and Frankie Felix with 1. That's about it for the scoring. You know, like I said at the beginning of the half, Coach Silva has to be pleased with the result here. I'm sure Coach Dean Shimamoto just is telling his team to just kind of be patient and look for good shots. Try to impose their will or their game, put their fingerprints on this game, allowing St. Louis right now or in the first half to dictate a lot of what happened there.
Iolani started uncharacteristically slowly to begin to open this game. St. Louis at one point led 10-2. Raiders called a 30-second timeout, and Frank Felix went into the game and brought a jolt of energy and got things going, and the Raiders took a lead. Right now they trail by 1, but since that kind of juncture in the first quarter, it's kind of been really tight.
Yeah, there's kind of several runs there of different kinds of basketball. There was a slow start by Iolani. There was a point there, I think there were 4 turnovers in a row, 2 for each team going back and forth, pushing the ball up and making an errant pass and coming back the other way, making another errant pass, just kind of scrambling there. Then there was a little bit of slowdown, patient basketball by both teams.
And, there's this thing called, not making excuses, just handing out information, but it's finals week here at Iolani School. Students got back from their Christmas vacation and don't have finals before break, and finals is Thursday and Friday of this week. And I thought of that when I saw the dance team, all of those girls out here, and it's the evening, and, we've got one more day of school, and then there's upper school final exams. So that always plays a part. So hopefully the Raiders can put together a strong second half year and get home and maybe do a little bit of studying.
Yeah.
Get ready for Wednesday. Iolani with it. This is Helam Baldomero. Trapped in the corner by Sykes. Gets away nicely, but steps on the end line.
Helam frustrated with that. Picked up his dribble a little too early in the corner. Got it knocked away and tried to drive baseline, looking to create something.
Jalen Smith with it for St. Louis. He'll spin and lay it up and in.
Nice spin move.
Jalen, the 6'6" son of Alika Smith.
I'm not sure where he got that height from, because Alika's definitely not.
And Canfort can't make the shot off the window. Helam Baldomero needs to tie his shoelaces. He knows that. We're not getting a timeout. He is guarding Jamison Nanuha, who works off a screen from Noah Purcell. Sykes cross court to Josh Smith. He'll try a 3-pointer over Hoagland. It's no good, and the ball goes out of bounds off Van Canfort. Crusaders looking to see if they can add to their 3-point lead here. Just getting started in the third quarter. Sykes to Purcell. Purcell stops, pops, banks one off the window. St. Louis now up by 5.
Another slow start by the Raiders. Going to have to figure this zone out.
Get secret weapon Frank Felix into the game. Here's Hoagland. Triple teamed. Baldomero and Canfort. Cole Hoagland.
Oh, nice give and go.
And they'll swirl it through the rim.
Yeah, they're going to have to do a lot more of that quick passing.
Nice teamwork by the brothers on the offensive end. And then on this side, Pugh gets called for the block. And the referee, and he'll get card for a technical foul. So that's four fouls, personal fouls on Hugh Hoagland, with 5:51 to go here in the third quarter.
Yeah, frustrating for Hugh. He's got to keep his composure there.
Definitely got the ball up high, but the body down low, is that the judgment?
Yeah, you know, it looked like he got a clean block. But referee saw some body contact below.
Perfect free throw by Smith. Lower gym's very quiet right now as he misses his second.
Those were for the foul. This is
two shots for the technical.
Yeah, or vice versa.
St. Louis will get the ball after this total of four foul shots. So far, one of three.
A lot of times it's harder to hit these free throws with nobody on the lane, all by yourself and the whole gym watching.
Two of four.
And the ball. Well, Hugh's teammates picked it up in the first half when he went out. Let's see if they can recreate that.
Crusaders leading by five. They can go up eight or seven. Wiley shot. Went in and out. Oh, was that the Nuha? Excuse me.
Yeah, the Nuha.
And then he got called for the foul after that.
Cole Hoagland showing some intensity there, going after that rebound.
There's Keelan. It's fouled by Smith. Alan Silva, call a timeout. Yeah. Talk it over with his Crusaders. Full timeout.
That possession alone, Crusaders almost made three different steals in the passing lanes. They're very athletic and quick, and Iolani's going to have to make sure they take care of the ball. I'm going to guess that Coach Silva wants to change the defense up a little bit here with Hugh out of the game. They probably want to change it up, give him a different look. Try to confuse the Raiders and see if the Raiders can respond. Down five here, almost midway through third quarter.
Last year, these two teams had some interesting results. The first time they played, St. Louis up at St. Louis in the second game of the ILH season, St. Louis won 52-50. Hugh Hoagland didn't play in that game. He was at a volleyball tournament. Then the second time they played, Iolani won convincingly after breaking a three-game losing streak. It was at that point where everybody was wondering, what happened to Iolani? They might not make the state tournament. And then they beat St. Louis 59-31. And then later on, the Raiders prevailed in the ILH tournament over St. Louis 47-40. And went on to win the league, and then went on to win the state title. Here's Baldomero. Genovia, he'll drive into Josh White, and gets flattened. St. Louis cannot convert at the other end, however. White and Purcell are still down on this side of the court. Genovia challenges them once again. This time his shot falls, and the foul is called. No foul the first time. This time, Genovia will go to the line to perhaps complete a three-point play, and a crucial one. The Raiders now trail it by three.
You might see Genovia laughing there. He ran into Josh White like it was a brick wall.
Josh White had a really
a stunned look on his face, right?
Big open mouth reaction. Genovia hits the three, completes the three-point play. Raiders now trail it by two. Just under 5 minutes to go here, third quarter. Sykes with it. He can't finish at the rim. Here come the Raiders. They got a two-on-one. Genovio take it himself. He's fouled by Noah Purcell. Those two have met on the football field before, and they met once again there at the Diamond Head basket.
Yeah, nice to watch basketball when terrific athletes are playing. Genovia just gliding to the hoop, challenging.
They're sharing a little, a bit of conversation and smiles. And Noah Purcell now, you know, regarded as one of the top inside linebackers in the state, but need to be reminded that he kind of started out as a basketball athlete and now is making his name for himself and on the football gridiron. Here's Josh White. Been harassed a bit by Genovia. Here's White playing point guard. Shovels it over to Smith. St. Louis slowing it down here a little bit. It's a tie game, 24-24. Inside to White. We'll get another shot. That one's also no good. Purcell with the third attempt. Ball called by the official way out here. No call. Was able to see Josh White doing something in there.
Yeah, looks like he got him on a hack on the arm there, on the rebound. Cole Hoagland working hard with his brother on the bench.
Clean up the perspiration on the court. We'll get started.
Well, Justin Genovia has scored 5 points, I believe, to close the gap here.
There he is with the ball. 3-point attempt, short.
Great rebound by Alabanza. He's open in the corner. Yeah, they have to move the ball quickly.
Then Kenford into the lane. His bounce pass goes out of bounds. Turns it over to St. Louis.
Good idea there. He thought Hoagland was going to cut a little to the basket there. Tried to lead him. Didn't quite connect on that.
Here is Noah Purcell. Jalen Smith. Chris Sykes. Purcell in the lane. Gets confronted by Cole Hoagland and ball goes over to Josh White.
Great pass by Purcell. Good vision in the lane.
See how the Raiders respond. Baldomero will try a three-pointer and he'll hit it.
Baldomero just kind of ho-hum, you know, put that ball up. He's not asked to shoot very often. Made the most of his opportunity there.
Nanuha enters with a three ball from the corner pocket. St. Louis up by a two again. Nice behind the back dribble by Genovia that frees him up for a three. That won't go. Cole Hoagland tried to scoop it back in. Here comes Purcell for the Raiders. He'll stop in the lane and bank one home. And he'll go to the line for the and one attempt.
Purcell letting out a primal yell there at the end after scoring.
And here comes Bumanglug and Frank Felix, Baldomero, and Alabanza will take a rest. Also, Cole Hoagland will head to the bench as Cameron Chang comes in for Iolani.
Some fresh legs for the Raiders. See if Coach Dean's chess move works out here.
Purcell cannot complete the three-point play.
There's Frankie with a rebound.
St. Louis up by four. Genovia attacking the rim, gets it to Van Kentfort. His corner three is nothing but net. Jamison Nanuha leaks out. He can't finish, but Chris Sykes cleans up his mess. And St. Louis is up by three again. 1:50 to go here, third quarter. Zenobia cutting to the lane. He's met at the basket by his friend, Noah Purcell. Another foul.
Again, it's just like several different games within one game. We got times where it's real calm and controlled, and then other times when it's just frenetic.
There are somewhat small crowd in the lower gym getting their money's worth. We're not joined by much of the Raider Nation because of that finals issue that I mentioned a few minutes ago. But I'm sure many of them are tuning in to the webcast. Iolani trailing it by three. Here's Purcell, double teamed. Throws it away. Frank Felix up with the steal.
Great pressure, nice trap. Caused a turnover. And look at who turned up with the ball, Frank Felix.
Here's that man again. Now he'll try to score. That bounces around, but he fouls Silva, who got the rebound. Getting some instruction from Coach Shimamoto.
I think he's got three fouls.
Trying to fine-tune that energy. Raiders applying some backcourt pressure.
Be interesting to see when Coach Dean decides to bring Hugh back into the game with four fouls.
It'll be his brother, Cole, coming in at the next dead ball. We're under a minute to go here in the third quarter. St. Louis leading it by a couple, and now four, as Smith lays it up and in.
Comes up limping a little bit.
Ball knocked away. Here's Nanuha. Gets another one. Just like that. Crusaders take a six-point lead.
I think they're cramps. Looks like his calves are cramping up.
Yeah. Smith limping to the bench.
That's the cramp walk.
All 6 foot six of him.
His dad, you can see his dad in the shot there, kind of giggling in that blue shirt.
Raiders need to respond here. They're down six. 25 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Purcell is going to get called for holding Bailey Alabanza on his cut to the rim.
Purcell has four fouls. He tells his coach he knew right away.
That was the first time he didn't foul Genovia, I think. And we got Bailey Alabanza. I love saying that name.
It's a great name.
It is. And Bailey Alabanza. This is his second. St. Louis leading it by five. Looking to make it more here. They'll hold it for the last shot. This is Junior Wiley. They'll kick it out to Purcell. Over to Silva. Nice pass to Sykes. And he puts it in off the window at the buzzer. St. Louis Crusaders lead it 39-32. We've got at least eight more minutes to play.
That was a textbook end of a quarter for a team to hold the ball and score.
Just to kind of recap, Iolani comes in at 2-0, leading the ILH Boys Division One, along with Marinal. Iolani defeated Punahou. Punahou is 1-1. St. Louis is 0-2. But that could change quickly, as it often does here in the ILH.
It looks like Coach Dean coming with you right away. Down seven. He's going to have to play with those four fouls. And try to affect the game. You know, he looked tentative with the two fouls. He looked tentative. He wasn't his normal shot blocking self. Like usually he would cheat off his man and try to go help his teammates with drives to the basket. He was just kind of staying down. Oh, they're going to spread it out.
Here we go with the fourth quarter. St. Louis with Silva, Nanuha, he has the ball. Wiley, Purcell, and Sykes.
Yeah, this is...
And here's Wiley. That's knocked out of bounds.
This strategy could backfire. I always thought, you know, if you try to hold the ball too early with a lot of time left, it could backfire on you because it changes your mindset. You know, you're not looking to score anymore. You're looking to just hold the ball. We'll see how it plays out.
It is somewhat opposite of what got St. Louis the 7-point lead that they enjoy now. This is a kind of deliberate offense that you would more attribute to Iolani over the years.
There's the turnover.
The turnover, there was no shot, yep. But they did take about a little less than a minute off the clock. And here's Baldomero with a three attempt. That's no good. Keavi Silva with a rebound. This time, Jamison Nanuha attacks the basket. A nice change of pace, lays it up with a right hand.
Coach Silva probably gives him the green light to attack and score it whenever he wants.
Saw a lane and he took it. Much the same as Baldomero just did. He's fouled going up. That stops the clock and puts Iolani at the line for two shots.
Yeah, no need to panic at this point if you're the Raiders. Just kind of do what Helam did, attack the basket, stop the clock, hit your free throws. At the other end, they're going to have to get some stops here.
Baldomero short on his second, and it's one of two. But Iolani gets the rebound. And throws it away. Here come the Crusaders. Keavi Silva drives the baseline. He gets bumped, but we get a travel call.
Well, Coach Silva's looking to sub him out after after that drive to the basket. Yeah, that's not the shot Coach Silva wanted, that's for sure.
Smith comes in to replace Silva. This is Bailey Alabanza. Cole Hoagland. They find Hugh Hoagland down low. Good ball movement by Iolani.
Great set play by the Raiders there. Lots of off.
Helam Baldomero thought he came up with a clean steal there. Foul called instead.
Yeah, the Raider fans in the gym also thought it was clean. And I'll throw my name in there, too.
They had a good look at it, but maybe a little biased. Chris Sykes, breakdown in the Iolani defense, and he lays it up and in. Puts the St. Louis lead back up to 8. 5:40 to go here in the fourth quarter. Alabanza trying to get it into Hugh Hoagland, but Jalen Smith with great defense. Gets knocked away. Some crazy basketball going on out there right now. No, Junior Wiley had two shots at it, could not convert. Here come the Raiders. Kick out to Genovia. Baldomero with it. Poked away from Hugh Hoagland. Need Hugh to get down into one of his comfortable spots.
Interesting. Silva, Coach Silva changed to a man defense.
Genovia drove against that defense.
Yeah.
Couldn't get the basket or the foul. And the Crusaders have it. Coach Alan Silva calls a timeout with 4:40 to go in the fourth quarter. St. Louis leads it 43-35. Dean Shimamoto could use this timeout as well.
Coach Silva's a veteran coach. He's really managing his team well, changing defenses, and confusing and frustrating the Raiders right now.
These two coaches met in the state championship final 3 years ago when Coach Silva was with Farrington and took them to a D2 title and then the D1 championship game. Iolani prevailed in that contest. That was Iolani's 10th state title.
Yeah.
And Iolani added another last season.
Coach Dean, more animated than I've seen him in a while in this huddle. You know, he's trying to get that sense of urgency into his players here. Again, no need to panic. Lots of time. Got to take care of your possessions. Got to play good defense. Play smart.
Early on here in the ILH season, just the third game for all the teams, but every game counts, and on every given night, any team can win. That cliche bore itself out in a big way last season when, as Coach Shimamoto said, he experienced every emotion, all sorts of ups and downs. Iolani, as we mentioned before, seemed destined to not even make the state tournament, and they eventually won the league title with a bunch of do-or-die situations and made the tournament and prevailed. Foul by the Raiders.
Yeah.
Iolani 6, so St. Louis will be in the bonus next time the Raiders are called for a foul.
Yeah, not sure about that call. I think Nunuha tripped a little on his own foot. Helam had pretty good position. Could have let that one go, probably. There was no turnover on.
Crusaders up 8. Trying to make it more. Sykes. This bounce pass to Purcell's. Got it rejected by Hugh Hoagland. Here come the Raiders. They need to convert. Cole Hoagland at the other end. Puts it up and in. Hugh Hoagland on one end. Cole Hoagland on the other. There's Junior Wiley. That's knocked out of bounds. St. Louis will retain possession.
Lots of time.
Tons of time. We've got 4:03 to go here in the fourth. There was a college team that overcame a 14-point deficit in the last, what was it, 138 or something? I was watching
is
that.
Is it Nevada?
That was insane.
Yeah. Nevada, New Mexico? Is that what it was?
Yeah, I believe so. It was in the pit in New Mexico. Nevada's first victory ever there, and in dramatic fashion. Game went into overtime, and they were able to win it there. That's what the three-point shot does. And a little bit of luck and a lot of defense. Our situation here is Iolani trails it by 6. St. Louis trying to take time off the clock. Junior Wiley cuts to the basket. He can't finish. Knocked away from Hoagland, but foul called on Junior Wiley.
Yeah, Hoagland's got to give that ball up quicker. He had Genovia on the wing ready to fly.
That is the 9th team foul on St. Louis. So next time they commit a foul, Iolani will be in the double bonus.
As much as you can handle the ball and dribble it up, that pass would travel the ball up the court a lot quicker. Bigger advantage.
He hits his first. A I unofficially have him with 7 points. He's played some limited minutes today because of foul trouble. His second shot is pure. That also cuts the St. Louis lead to 4 points.
Nice stroke by Hugh. Easy steal for Helam.
Hugh with it. Drives down the lane. Pass to his brother. His turnaround shot. That's knocked away.
Hugh very active there.
Helam Baldomero, three-pointer. No good. Hoagland with a big rebound inside. He'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, Hoagland, you know, really now starting to put his thumbprint on this game, fighting for rebounds, fighting for loose balls, knocking down free throws.
He made two in a row.
Yeah, you know, as soon as that came out of my mouth, I thought, don't do that. Jinxer. He'll get this one.
Cuts the Crusader lead to three. 3:17 to go, third quarter. Josh White into the game for St. Louis. He will replace Jalen Smith. Jalen did some good defending of Hugh Hoagland while he was in there. Well, it's not going to be Jalen Smith. Junior Wiley will be taking a seat. Manuha brings it across the timeline. St. Louis will go back. Oh, we might get a 5 second call, and we do. Justin Genovia. Manuha has some problems dribbling the ball. That's all he needed to.
Genovia just, again, amazing quickness to stay in front of Manuha. Manuha is an excellent, excellent ball handler. And Genovia was with him step for step.
Under 3 minutes to go here. Raiders trailing it by three. Nice bounce pass by Hugh Hoagland to Genovia. He can't finish, neither can Cole Hoagland. Hugh Hoagland comes up with a steal at the other end. He'll dump it off to his brother, Cole. And he laid it up and in. Josh White throws the ball nearly out of bounds. Turnover, St. Louis. Iolani has it. Raiders trail by one. Here's Cole trying to make it two in a row, and he does. Iolani now leads 44-43. 2:08 to go here in the fourth quarter.
I think that's their first lead of the game.
A quarter that began with St. Louis leading it by seven. Josh White can't put an end to the Iolani run with his three-pointer. Josh White's asking Alan Silva for a timeout, I believe. Can't do that. Iolani's got the ball. Here's Justin Genovia. Raiders now leading it, 44-43, 1:40 to go. Got a little bump there as some of the Raiders cycled to the basket.
Coach Silva, a little while ago, had his hands on top of his head, kind of wondering where his lead went. Nice little spurt by the Raiders.
It's always risky, as we mentioned when you started the fourth. You know, what was happening led St. Louis to a 7-point lead, and they deviated from that. You never know what's going to happen in the game of basketball or any game, but now the Raiders, with that free throw, lead it by two, and Genovia has one more. That shot's no good. Hustle for it. Baldomero and Silva in the corner. Sorry, Manuha.
Yeah. This game is far from over, but what a great comeback by the Raiders.
Bailey Alabanza, normally he'll shoot that three, but that's not part of the idea.
Yeah, he had Coach Shimamoto in his ear right then.
Bailey, a great three-point shooter. You never see him that alone. So you have to rethink that. Here's Hugh Hoagland.
Yeah.
Guarded by Josh White. Way out here by the midcourt line. Josh, all of 360 pounds.
Coming out. They're going to force him to come out.
Ball called on Jamison Nuha with 59.2 seconds to go. Send Cole Hoagland to the line.
Oh, Nuha fouls out. That's a big loss for St. Louis.
Coach Silva has some time to make a substitution. He'll use that. Give Josh White, in particular, a rest right in front of us.
Yeah, he gets a full minute. Noah Brown coming in.
A little long there. He will get another one. We'll try to make this a three-point game. Cannot convert. Crusaders with it. This is Keavi Silva working against Justin Genovia. Puts it in the corner to Smith. Smith turns. Spins, has it swatted out of bounds by Hugh Hoagland.
That's the Hugh I know, the Hugh that I saw in the Iolani Classic. Again, he was a little more timid earlier in the game with some foul trouble. He's doing that with four fouls now,
playing
his normal game.
That's the Hugh Hoagland you sometimes see on the Iolani boys varsity volleyball team as well. Getting his hand up on a ball with good timing.
Yeah. That time, Hugh, as he's coming off the court, kind of patting his chest and telling Coach Dean, hey, sorry for missing those free throws. That's my fault.
So St. Louis, now without any timeouts, they trail it by two. 42.2 seconds to go. Iolani, amazingly, has four timeouts remaining. If I'm not mistaken, that 30-second timeout when it was early and things didn't seem to have the energy was the one timeout Dima Shimamoto took. Frank Felix came into the game. Noah Bumonglog was reinserted into the game. They brought some energy to the court. And then from then on, it's been kind of a tight game. But in the third quarter, St. Louis kind of extended the lead. They began the fourth, as we mentioned, with a seven-point lead. Started to be a little bit more deliberate.
Yeah, I think Hugh turned it up. He started not worrying about, the foul calls or the physicality of St. Louis. And definitely showed up in this fourth quarter.
Hugh picked up two early fouls in the first quarter, then picked up two fouls on one play.
Yep.
When he felt he didn't foul a Crusader going to the basket and then picked up a technical. Here's St. Louis with it, having some trouble inbounding the ball. Interception by Genovia, and he'll lay it up and in. Raiders increase their lead to four. 32 seconds to go. Purcell with it. He'll take an 18-foot jumper, bounces around. Hoagland with a huge rebound, gets it to Genovia.
I like how Hugh got rid of that ball quickly. Gave it to Justin there. Let some time tick off the clock. What a great steal by Genovia and finish on the other end.
Time was ticking on that inbound and had to go long. And Genovia, maybe using some of those wide receiver skills, ball judgment.
Yeah, definitely.
Did a great job getting to that ball. Ball to Merrill. Big free throw.
Iolani in the double bonus now, so they get two free throws on any foul against St. Louis.
Elam makes them both. Raiders lead it by six. Sykes with a two. 10 seconds to go. Raiders will take their time. They inbound it. 5 seconds. 5.7 seconds to go. Baltimore will go back to the line. Incredible fourth quarter by Iolani.
Yes.
Lots going against them. And we should also mention that Kavika Lee is not with the team. I believe he is ailing, sick. Yeah. Kind of an illness ran through the team when they came back from San Diego. Caught up with Bailey Alabanza, caught up with Justin Genovia. Kavika Lee actually started the last game at Mid-Pacific, so that's somebody that's in the thick of Coach Dean Shimamoto's rotation.
Well, he led the team in scoring that day, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he had 16 points from what I remember.
Brother of John Lee. John may be watching this webcast. Shout out to him. Hope he's having a good time at college.
Yeah. But again, this is a this really tells me a lot about the Raiders and they can come back not playing their best basketball through the three quarters, you know, facing adversity with Hugh getting those fouls, figuring out a way to win, figuring out a way to turn it up. Let's see if Helam can cap it off with two free throws.
Off the front rim, but Helam Baldomero comes up with the loose ball off the rim. And that'll be it. Iolani Raiders win it, move to 3-0 by the score of 49-44. St. Louis drops to 0-3 on the season, but this St. Louis club is not an 0-3 club.
No. They're dangerous. It's, you know, it's a good win. It wasn't pretty for the Iolani Raiders, but any win in the ILH is a good win.
And as we often talk with Coach Shimamoto, you know, he always mentions that typically after losses that there's always something to learn.
Mm-hmm.
This is a victory, but there's a lot to learn from this.
Oh,
you know, there's a lot, some adversity, there's situations that came up, and they came through.
Most definitely. I think, you know, from what I saw, that their overall energy, the Raiders' overall energy through the whole game, was inconsistent. You know, they brought it, they went on their runs and they were very successful. But when they didn't have their energy, they definitely let St. Louis predict what was going to happen.
So, thank you for joining us for this webcast. Iolani returns to action on Saturday, January 14th. They'll host Kamehameha here in the lower gym. And then a road game at Marinol next Wednesday, 6 o'clock, your alma mater.
Mm-hmm.
They're doing well, as is everybody in the ILH. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I saw Coach Kelly Grant in the audience taking mental notes, trying to figure out game plans. Again, should be an interesting ILH this year. If St. Louis is 0-3, and they play like that, and they play their game, they can surprise some people.
Thank you for joining us for this doubleheader. Iolani girls team won 60-24 against Sacred Hearts, and then the Iolani Raiders boys team won 49-44. We would like to thank all of the people who make these webcasts possible. That begins with the physical plant and athletic department who help us with this broadcast location. Timothy R. Cottrell, our headmaster, our head of school, and his administration for supporting these webcasts. And our hardworking Iolani Live and One Team Network crew, led by Dane Kurhar and Mitch Viernes. We've got Iolani senior Maddie Ikeda with us on the camera, and Vito Wecki, a junior, who's handling the audio. And thanks to Director of Communications, Kathy Lee Chong, and my partner, Michael Mong here. This is John Tominaha signing off. Until next time, good night, everybody.
Good night. Thanks, John.
Aloha. Aloha.